गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, होप सो यू आर डूइंग वेल फॉर रिविजन पर्पज फॉर क्लास 10th चैप्टर नंबर 1 केमिस्ट्री केमिकल रिएक्शन एंड इक्वेशन। हियर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द एक्टिविटी विच आज गिवन इन योर टेक्सट बुक चिल्ड्रन। सो इन द टेक्सट बुक द एक्टिविटी नंबर 1.1 इज गिवन विच इज बेस्ड ऑन द कंबशन रिएक्शन एंड एक्सोथर्मिक एंड ऑक्सीडेशन रिएक्शन। हियर यू रिक्वायर दिस एक्टिविटी रिक्वायर नीड्स ऑफ टीचर्स असिस्टेंट एंड इट वुड बी बेटर इफ स्टूडेंट्स वियर आई प्रोटेक्शन। सो ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस मेनी अ टाइम, सो दिस इज नथिंग बट द एक्टिविटी विच इज बेस्ड ऑन द कंबशन और वी कैन से दैट ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ मैग्नेशियम। सो वेन वी टॉक्ड अबाउट द एम ऑफ द एक्टिविटी, इट इज दे रिलेटेड विथ we have to study about the combustion reaction or exothermic reaction by taking the example of burning of magnesium in the air. So for this activity we required the particular materials. So you can just have idea from that particular aim, that is magnesium ribbon, sandpaper, tong, burner and watch glass. See children, what is tong? Tong is nothing but it is the one holding apparatus which is used in the chemical lab to hold any of the wire or any of the material. So here we have to just look on the particular procedure. Then after we have to take a magnesium ribbon which is about 2 cm long and we have to rub it by the sandpaper. Already we have discussed why there is a need to rub this magnesium ribbon to remove out the oxide layer. Then after we have to hold it with the pair of tongs and we have to burn it using a spirit lamp or burner what we have available, and then we have to collect the ash which is formed in the watch glass which is also, so you can see in the diagram next slide. So burn the magnesium ribbon keeping it as far as possible from the eyes, otherwise you have to wear the spectacles to protect your eyes. So there is a rubbing of sandpaper, rubbing of the magnesium ribbon by the sandpaper to remove out the oxide layer to make the reaction more feasible. Magnesium ribbon is there, always rubbed before it is going to be used. So here you can see the diagram. In the diagram we have a tong. See, you can see the tong which is there hold by the hand. It is holding the magnesium ribbon. So hold. Tong is nothing but it is the one holding apparatus which is used in the chemistry lab. So burner we have and china dish in which we have the white color powder of magnesium oxide. Magnesium oxide when dissolved in water it produces magnesium hydroxide, so it is basic in nature children. So from that diagram and procedure we observed that magnesium ribbon burns with white dazzling or brilliant white flame or white powder of magnesium oxide is again going to be formed when we talked about. Then after when we talked about the particular, after observation when we talked about the particular reaction, chemical reaction. So magnesium ribbon is nothing but magnesium Mg when it is going to burn in the air. So air is containing oxygen as a combustible gas. So here we have 2 Mg plus O2 which gives MgO. Here in the form of white dazzling light, heat is produced. So we can say that whenever magnesium ribbon burn in the air, it produces large amount of heat in the form of white dazzling light. So we can say that from this whole activity, we can conclude that whenever magnesium ribbon burn in the presence of air, it produce or it evaluate large amount of heat and light. So we can say that this reaction is known as combustion reaction or exothermic reaction, and burn magnesium ribbon burns in the presence of air. So we can say that here oxidation of magnesium is also occur. So magnesium ribbon burns in the presence of air is categorized as oxidation or combustion or exothermic reaction. Thank you children.